Welcome back to The District, everybody. My name is Dave Vellante.
And I'm John Furrier.
I'm Stu Miniman, and you're watching theCUBE's coverage of AWS Public Sector Summit 2018.
Celebration and informational sessions with customers from Amazon Web Services, GovCloud, and also international.
Get best practices, find use cases, and just see what the ecosystem's all about in terms of how to make it work with the cloud.
The ecosystem here is really robust. I mean, you see the consultancies, you see every technology vendor.
It's not only the private sectors that are talking about moving to the cloud, it's government.
The CIA made that decision. That was sort of the shot heard around the world as it relates to cloud adoption, not just for public sector, but for commercial as well.
The one thing public sector does really well is capture and collect a lot of data. Mm. The one thing we haven't done well, in my view, is the utilization, the access to that data for decision making, for analysis, for thinking about how do you improve end user experience, stakeholder experience.
Amazon is light years ahead of the rest of the cloud guys. The reason for that is they made the decision early on to make the risk around cloud. As a result of that, they have so many lessons learned that are beyond all the other cloud providers. That wouldn't happen to Amazon today.
What's your sense of that lead, even subjectively?
I think it's between 5 and 10 years.
People are crying foul. Make it a multi-cloud, multi-vendor, kind of be fair, you know, fairness. Amazon's not asking for sole source. They're just saying, we're responding to the bid, and we're the only ones that actually can do it.
What we've struggled with government customers, with healthcare and commercial enterprise, is people have their data locked up in little silos.
If you have those data assets, you're able to access those data assets, now you can think about using that data in a more business mission context around the services you offer.
Build newer systems faster and get lower costs, more efficiency done faster, and this is disrupting not only their business model, but how they buy technology, the role of the supplier in that piece of the equation.
For years, we've talked about the economics of cloud, the scale of cloud, the marginal economics, looking much more like software, and that's clearly been to Amazon's advantage.
With the cloud, with serverless, with all the tools that you've got, it's going to cost you nothing to establish an application. You have enough tools to compete against the big establishments out there.
Here in DC, it's almost a Silicon Valley-like dynamic where stuff that was never funded before is getting funded because they can do cloud. So you're seeing kind of a resurgence of mission-driven entrepreneurship.
All the customer wants is the outcome, the functionality of the software for it to be performant and do what the vendor said that it was going to do.
In Amazon, all you do is click a button, and no matter where you store it, it's encrypted and protected.
We can have security tied directly into the entire development cycle all the way through so that there are no surprises, right? Fixing cybersecurity holes at the end is 30 times more expensive than having just done it up front in the beginning across the board.
The CIA said today, they said on the worst day in the public cloud, security is far better than it is in my client server systems.
For large enterprise and public sector federal government customers, we still have that feature of private offers, which enables the customer and the vendor to negotiate on price and terms, but still transact digitally through Marketplace and have it all seamlessly billed by AWS.
We now have over 22,000 nonprofits using AWS to keep going and make sure that no nonprofit would ever fail for lack of infrastructure.
Game Changer really focuses in on leveraging gaming, technology, and innovation to support patients' rights to play, learn, and socialize. Experts 1,200 miles apart, we're able to collaborate in real time through the cloud, through Amazon Sumerian, to make a VR experience where patients about to receive aortic valve replacements could actually go through human hearts in virtual reality and simulate the surgery that they would soon be receiving.
In Bahrain, a small country in the Middle East, they realized the transformative opportunity with cloud computing and they decided to take the lead.
By having Amazon in Bahrain, it will help stimulate the innovation of our citizens. The people are the innovators, they are going to be our future developers and entrepreneurs. Making them ready for the cloud is going to help us succeed.
The other benefit you get is the SaaS deployment model and time to value.
It used to take us 2 years for a change. Yeah. Now it's going to take us weeks for a change.
I don't believe in a wholesale kind of approach to replatforming. I think leveraging things like serverless containers, microservices, you can start to take a bite at the apple in a phased approach.
You're not going to have all your stuff in the cloud if you're the Air Force, or if you're the Army, because you have 75 years of data that you've got to push in. So over the next 10 years, there's going to be this quote hybrid environment where you'll have some stuff in the cloud, some stuff in the in a hybrid world, some stuff on-prem, right?
We've got agencies that are going all in on AWS, and I think that's just a sign of the times.
Data centers, I mean, anyone, we're a startup 9 years into it, we've never had a data center. I think most startups don't. But
born in the cloud.
Born in the cloud.
We're going to be training 100,000 people across Europe, Middle East, and Africa with a combination of all of these programs.
The world is changing, and if they're not on the cloud, they're going to be left behind.
Congratulations on your success. AWS, public sector, doing great, global public sector. The ecosystem looks good. You guys did a good job, so congratulations.
For Dave Vellante, John Furrier, I'm Stu Miniman, and as always, thanks so much for watching theCUBE.